Simon, go back, is the popular slogan that strikes us when we think of Simon Commission in India. But do you know why did Indians oppose the Simon Commission? Let's know the story behind it and have a look at today's topic. Simon Commission, year 1928. The British government constituted the Simon Commission under Sir John Simon. The commission had 7 members of the British Parliament. The aim of the commission was to look into the functioning of the constitutional system in India and suggest necessary changes. They wanted to assess the effectiveness of Government of India Act 1919. By discussing the constitutional reforms needed for India, they just wanted to show Indians that British were sincere in the efforts of providing power and authority to Indians. But by this time, Indians had already seen enough of cruelties of the British rule in India. Indians found the Simon Commission futile in terms of its objective. The Simon Commission had no Indian member. They were all British. And it meant that Indians had no right in determining its own future. Thus, the commission was widely rejected by Indian National Congress, Muslim League, and many other political associations. No constitutional reform was acceptable to the Indians without a fair representation. This decision of boycott was formally decided in the Madras session of Indian National Congress in December 1927. So, when Simon Commission landed in Mumbai on February 3, 1928, there was country-wide protest. Black flags were shown all over along with the slogan, "Simon, go back." But the British did not accept the opposition and they responded with Lathi charge and tried to terrorize Indians. A lot of people were killed. When the commission reached Lahore in October 1928, it was rejected with a peaceful protest under the leadership of Lala Lajpat Rai. But he was brutally beaten up by the police, which gave him serious injuries, and soon, on November 17, 1928, Lala Lajpat Rai died. Though a revolutionary, Lion of Punjab died of his injuries, but his courage and spirit to ensure freedom for the country survived with other Indians who continued to fight against the British suppression. The sacrifice of Lala Lajpat Rai and many other Indians forced the British to pacify the Indians by giving platform to the Indians for political representation. Finally, the report of Simon Commission was published in 1930. It recommended representative government in the provinces, which paved the way for the Indian National Congress. Indian National Congress formed its government in most of the provinces of India. So, this was all about Simon Commission in India. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and leave your views in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe Constructing Minds for more academic videos.